Hey everyone, this is Linda Johnson from BrewNymph.com with another edition of Let's Get a Beer Florida. This is the weekend of February 17th, week of February 19th, and even beyond that. So we are here with a look at Florida brewery events, beer fest, and special event info, and we're highlighting local happenings around the Jax Beach, St. Augustine areas for the upcoming week. And a heads up look into the future, because as you know, we like looking into the future, so you guys get your tickets and be prepared. First, we do a quick recap. You might have noticed the cup I have. This is from DeLand Craft Beer Fest, which took place last Saturday, February 10th. I have a recap story on the site right now about that. This was a great fest. It was like walking around hometown USA, Main Street USA. The setup was such that you had a lot of room to move around. The brewery tents were lined on either side of the street. Plenty of space to move around, lots of great beer, lots of great people, of course. And it was just a really, really good time. Bright blue skies, it was great. So take a look at the recap with a lot of photos, a lot of brewery info. I tried to get some news on the breweries while I did this. And take a look at that. I think you'll find some good stuff in there. The organizers did a great job, and thanks to everybody for Volusia Beer Week for another really, really great fest. I had a great time. All right, we're gonna start talking with some news here, okay? This just in, and I'm recording this on Friday. This is, February 16th, right? I'm recording this from BrewNymph HQ, otherwise known as my house. And this just in, Tampa Bay Brewing Company will be distributing in Jacksonville, and these launch events will be starting around the area on Monday, February 19th. I just put a story on BrewNymph.com about this. I have the schedule of the launch events. It's also on the calendar page. So take a look at that. I got some quotes in there from a statement that I obtained, and thanks to Tampa Bay Brewing Company for that info, by the way. And take a look at that. I think you guys are gonna like it. And on the other side, I got this coaster from Tampa Bay Brewing in Ybor. I've been there a few times. Also been to the West Chase location. And in addition to some pretty awesome beers that are always solid, always reliable, they have some really good food there too at their brew pubs. So if you're ever out in Tampa, Ybor, West Chase, make sure you stop at Tampa Bay Brewing, get the beer, get the food. You will have a great time there, I guarantee it. On the flip side of this koozie is Reef Donkey, and that is their American Pale Ale, one of their cores, which will be making its way into Jacksonville draft and cans. And I know I'm looking forward to this. There will be more of these in my fridge, and I won't even have to stop in Tampa to get those anymore. So very cool news, and congratulations to Tampa Bay. Looking forward to seeing them up here. By the way, this Reef Donkey did win a medal at GABF in 2014. So it's a pretty good beer, right? Also, they will be distributing their Quat, which is a golden kumquat ale. I had this at Jupiter Fest, not this past time, but a year ago, and found it to be really refreshing. So a beer that's a little bit different, and I think you guys will like it. I liked it. I'm looking forward to getting some of that again as well. And by the way, you heard it here first, okay? Woohoo! All right. So here are the launch events for Tampa Bay Brewing around Jax. February 19th, Beers 30 San Marco and Grape and Grain Exchange. February 20th, Mellow Mushroom Southside and Mellow Mushroom Jax Beach. February 21st at Really Good Beer Stop and another location that's not quite announced yet. So check all those out and welcome to Jax. All right, in other news, I reported this one a few weeks ago, and now we're starting to see some of these launch events come around as well. This again is Walking Tree Brewery out of Vero Beach. And I have some events on the Tap This page for March the 2nd up in Fernandina, which is just north of the Jacksonville area, if you guys are familiar with that. And I'm sure some more will be coming as they feed in along the way as well. You'll be able to get the Walking Tree beers on draft around the Jax area, and those events and those beers will be rolling out. So stay tuned for that coming up soon. All of this will be on the Tap This page as I see them. A lot of them are on there now. So looking a little bit ahead, keeping with the Jacksonville area for right now, we do have Riverside Craft Beer Festival. And yeah, that's a real beer in the glass. This is my glass from last year. And that will be happening on February 24th underneath the Fuller Warren Bridge. I have a preview story on BrewNymph.com. Did an interview with the event chair. Take a look at that. Some really good insights there that I got from him just to write that article. And of course, I'll be there again next Saturday on the 24th. Find me, say hi. I love that stuff, okay? And you will also be able to sample some beers from some new up-and-coming breweries, Legacy Ale Works and the new Fishware that's going in up in the Murray Hill area sometime in 2018. And more to come on Riverside Craft Beer Fest. If you don't have those tickets, get them. It was my understanding that the VIPs were close to selling out last I saw. And in other Jax news, let's stay with that for right now. I got a sneak peek the other day of Blind Rabbit over in Jax Beach, the current whiskey burger joint, and they're putting in their new brew house. I got a look at some of that equipment. It had just come in while I was there, and Jeff, the owner, was putting some of that equipment together, showed me around a little bit in that brew house, so I'll be having more on that soon. So stay tuned for that, lots of news there. Pretty cool development right there, and we're looking forward to that, so stay tuned for some more information on the Blind Rabbit Brewing Company at the Blind Rabbit Burger and Whiskey Joint, okay? That's all in Jack's speech. So what I want to do now is let's take a look at some of the events, keeping with the Jack's theme for right now, on the beers, on the event page. Well, no, actually, I guess I'm going to change gears. Can't even read my own script, right? I'm first going to run up some of the Beer Fest events happening around Florida, and then we'll get to the Jack's events. So February 17th, which is Saturday, Jay Wakefield Wakefest anniversary in Miami. Big beer fest, block party fest, guest breweries, new tappings, all kinds of stuff. That's in Miami. The Florida Craft Brew and Wing Fest in Vero Beach, also on February 17th. I have a recap about this event from last year on my site. Take a look at that. This is one huge fest. Gets upwards of 10,000 people there. It's a food wing fest. They judge the wings, lots of craft beer, two music stages. It's a great time down there. So take a look at the recap story from 2017. If you're in the Vero Beach area, grab some tickets and head over there. We've got Bowiegan's anniversary in Orlando, Beer, Bourbon, and Barbecue Fest. This one's in Tampa. Hops for Heroes at Ferg's Sports Bar in St. Pete. Greater Orlando Craft Beer Fest. It's a pub crawl type event. This is all February 17th. Bonita Brew Fest in Southwest Florida. And Food Trucks of America Craft Beer and Food Truck Fest in a Panhandle. So those are some of your Beer Fest beer events around the state happening on the 17th. Gonna take a quick look ahead to the 24th. Again, Fort Myers Brewing has a 5th anniversary bash on the 24th. Proof Brewing Winterfest was rescheduled from last weekend due to weather. MIA Beer Company anniversary in Miami. Of course, Riverside Fest, I already mentioned that. And let's take a really quick look ahead into March, because again, you want to be prepared. Get these tickets, because I know some of these are going to sell out. Tampa Bay Beer Week starts March 3rd. Big beer week, lots of events all over Tampa. If you happen to be there, make sure you stop in at some of those events. Those are all listed on TampaBayBeerWeek.com, by the way. The FBG Fest, Florida Brewers Guild. And no, I don't have a beer in this one right now. This will be on March the 3rd as well, happening out there in Tampa along the riverfront. I have a recap story from last year on my site about that. And if you're looking for a beer trip, or if you're already in the Tampa area, check that out. Benefits the FBG. And also the next day on Sunday, March the 4th, Best Florida Beer winners will be announced. They just had the judging. And if you might recall, I talked to Phil from Wicked Barley about that last week when I interviewed him at Wicked Barley. They submitted some entries, as I'm sure a lot of local breweries did. And we'll find out the winners of all of those Sunday, March 4th at Best Florida Beer. Those tickets will sell out, by the way. Also, looking ahead into March, Naples Craft Beer Fest on March 3rd. South Florida Hops Fest in Miami also on the 3rd. And just a little bit ahead, because I do have all of this on the site, and there are events even beyond this in March and April, but just a little bit of a heads up, we're still halfway through March here. Annual Fooder for Thought at Green Bench in St. Pete. And of course, we have one of the ultimate beer fests in the state, that being Hoona Day, Hoonapoo's Day, March the 10th in Tampa. New location this year, Raymond James Stadium, as opposed to the park where it has been held. So it looks like it's going to be a bigger event this year, actually. My first time attending Hoona Day was last year, so I was a Hoona Day virgin last year. I have a story about that recap on the site. Check it out. Lots of good info, lots of good pictures there. And more events, like I said, are listed on the site. Be sure to look at that. Be prepared, like Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts. Those Girl Scout cookies are out, by the way. I know there's pairings going on. I have a couple of boxes here in the kitchen, which are pretty awesome. And luckily, I have not been eating those like crazy. I've been really rationing those and reducing the intake, but they're awesome, right? All right, so now let's take a look at some of the local highlights happening around Jax this week and a little bit into the future. I like to call this segment All Jaxed Up, okay? So we'll talk about some Jacksonville events. I'm recording this on Friday, and tonight at Hyperion, there will be a unique cheese beer tapping. I mentioned that one last week. I have information about that on the site as well. If you happen to be around the Springfield area, check into that. Sounds pretty unique, pretty interesting. Sunday the 18th, running of the Bulls 5K at Intuition. February 19th, which is Monday, is President's Day, hence the shirt. I don't really have too much more to say about that other than it's probably a day off for lots of you guys, and red, white, and blue and all that stuff. Also, those Tampa Bay Brewing launch events I mentioned earlier will start to happen on Monday the 19th. In addition to that, we've got pint nights, ladies nights, trivia, all kinds of things going on. All of those are listed on the Tap This page, and you can access that 24 hours a day. Insomnia, 3 a.m, go to my site. It'll probably put you to sleep, right? So hey, I provide a worthwhile service to everybody. But I do update that daily as I see events, and you can look at that anytime. It's always up there. So also 224, I mentioned Riverside Fest. We do have some other interesting events going on. Barrel-aged stouts will be featured at Hoptinger Jax Beach. That's the 24th. Southern Swells with a double can release this time at noon. Hops and Hounds fundraiser at Veterans United. And there's a new tapping and a memorial beer that will be tapped at Green Room Brewing. That's all on the 24th. Doggy Graf fundraiser at Bold City Brewery, the main brewery. And looking a little bit ahead again, Sunday the 25th, Foodie Fair with Jack's Mom's Blog at Engine 15 downtown. And heads up into March for you homebrewers. Gastrofest Jax, March 24th. If you're a homebrewer and would like to submit your entry, you better get on that because it's limited entrance. That portion of the event for Gastrofest will be held at River City Brewing. Get those entries in if you're interested in doing that. I've been a judge there a couple of years. Pretty cool event, and it would be nice to see a few more homebrewers take part in that. And as I see more events, like I said, I always add them. It's more than just Facebook stuff. I scour a lot of sources. It's a lot of work I put into that. I also have some news briefs and things on that Tap This page relative to Jacksonville. If you're looking for the Beer Fest and Florida events, that's on the Beer Sphere page, and I do have little heads up things there as well. And you know what, guys? For right now, that's kind of it. Quick and dirty this month, or this week. Quick and dirty with these events. No guest interview this time. I'll have another one hopefully next week, if not the following week. And that's pretty much all there is for now. So have a great week, everybody. See you around a beer somewhere. And see you at the next Beer Fest, and might as well get that Riverside because that's going to be here by the time I do this again next week. So let's get a beer, Florida. Thanks for